Hey gang, welcome back to the ranch, where you can experience the ranch life and escape the ordinary every single day with our 30 and 30, 30 vlogs in 30 days. We're coming up towards the end of it, actually. I think we're day 22 today, and it's been an interesting 22 days. We went from waiting to have calves to having calves. I mean, that's really how this time has gone. We've done quite a few projects together. We've got some big projects started, and in some ways I hate to see it end, but we've got a few days left, and we're gonna make the most of them. So today I've already went out and fed. I've fed the cows, which is actually really good during calving time, because when you feed them, they're all gonna come and gather up. And our cows, for some reason, really like to have calves in the morning. So, except for, you know, yesterday, the first calf, which was born right before sunset. But overall, our cows like to have calves in the morning. So how that works is when I go out and feed them, I'm able to gather everybody up, and I can see exactly what's going on. They're going to come in for food, usually, up until a certain point. But we can gather them up, and then we can kind of see what's going on. So the cows are actually over here eating breakfast right now, hanging out. And it's a really good time to just kind of drive through them, make sure nobody has a calf hanging out of them, anything like that. It's also a good chance to take a look at udders and see if anybody's got got their milk coming in really hard. Like number 27 there, we can see if I can get by this cow, that she does have some milk coming in. Her bag's starting to swell a little bit, so that's a good sign. The other interesting thing about doing it this way is that obviously everybody gathers up, and then you're going to be able to see who doesn't come in for food, and those that don't come in for food obviously have something going on. So what I can see is one cow out there, just a black speck from where I stand, and that cow is obviously separated from the herd. Now my guess would be it is number 130 with her calf, that she's coming back in. She's hungry, she wants breakfast too, and she's comfortable enough with me and the herd and everything else that she will bring her calf back, even, you know, maybe a little over 12 hours after being born. So that she's gonna bring her calf back. Some cows won't do that. Some cows will leave themselves separated for days until they kind of feel comfortable enough to bring their calf back to the herd. And I'm not really sure if it's a comfort issue. I mean, there is obviously safety in the herd, so that's a good thing too. But we're gonna swing down, we're gonna check them out, and we're gonna take a quick round around the place just to make sure there's no cows that are hidden that we're not able to see that might be having a calf this morning. So let's go see how the new one is doing. And honestly, that's really all I have to see. That calf is up, it's moving, it's walking with its mom. Obviously, that's the same calf that was born yesterday, number one, a little heifer, and seems to be doing just great. Where she's taking her calf, I don't know. Eventually, she'll obviously make it back to the herd. She's on her way kind of that direction until I came up and bugged her, so. Our plan for today is to keep an eye on calves, obviously, or cows and calves. Now that one has had a calf, it wouldn't surprise me if we have a couple more today. I also have to run to town at some point. I have to go to the feed store. I'm gonna pick up something called mag cake today, if they have any. And what that does is it's a special kind of cake that includes like a high dose of magnesium. These cows are starting, they're still coming in for hay, obviously, every single morning. But they are going out and they're eating this grass, which is not much for grass right now. It's greening up, it's starting to grow, but they're out here eating away. This little tiny short grass that they're eating has basically zero magnesium in it, and they need magnesium to produce milk. It's actually really bad timing if you think about it. They're having calves. What they have out here in the field is not gonna produce good enough milk for calves. So we have to make sure that they get the vitamins they need. So we're gonna get them this magnesium infused cake, which then we'll begin feeding every day to give them that boost of magnesium that they're not getting from the grass that they're out here chomping down on. So that's our plan for today. The kids want to come out and see the new baby. I've told them that they have to wait until they finish their homework or school. Actually, it's not even homework, it's school now. They're gonna finish school this morning. Once they're done with that, I told them that we could come out and take a look at the baby also. So we'll bring you along for that, and we'll continue. It's just another day on the ranch. Kenzie, you get to wear your pajamas to school.
Yeah.
Is it cool?
Yeah, I'm freezing.
Go get a blanket.
Oh, you're funny. What are you working on?
Math.
Math. Is it hard?
A little bit.
What's 9 times 8?
9 times 8, 72.
Good job. All right, well, finish your math, and then when you're done with school today, what do we get to go do?
Baby calf.
Baby calf, all right.
Dad needs a name.
We have some good suggestions of some names. We'll talk about them, okay?
Okay.
Okay. While the kids are finishing up their homework, we are going to run to the post office, drop off today's shipment of beef jerky that was ordered on the website. We're going to go by the feed store, get ourselves that mag cake, maybe some few bonuses. I don't know what else we're going to get while we're there. Then we'll get our butts back here where we can check cows again. So a lot of times this time of year especially, it always seems like I'm making quick trips to town. I'm turning around, I have to run back in, and I gotta go get something, then come back out. It's always like really, really quick dashes to town, especially during calving. But we've got a little break now, so we're gonna head in and get what we need and get back.
Life's like a road that you travel on. One day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where the blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and the lovers soar, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate, break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today. Love you now like I love you then. This is a road and these are the hands. Tennessee
There we go, all set, loaded up, ready to go, and head back towards home.
All right, we're back home. We've got our cake, our lick, and we're gonna go see if school is over with. Probably grab some lunch and then get the kids out to meet the new calf and probably christen it with a name, because that's what kids do. So meet me back out here in just a few minutes and we'll take off. Alrighty, gang, lunch is done. I probably still have some of it in my teeth. We're gonna go find the kids. They're out riding bikes and doing their thing. We're gonna grab them and see if they want to come down and meet the new calf. And I do believe that they are going to unveil the calf's name as well. So let's go grab them. We're all gonna squeeze in the front. We're all gonna pretend we like each other. Okay, hold on, we gotta get... You guys all get in and then I'll figure out how to get in. Hold on, Grace. I'm gonna move this.
Can I close it?
Okay. I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Can I get in?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Buckle up.
All right, we made it. We're in. Everybody's in, right?
Yes.
Don't wreck us. Aim for the gate, buddy. Can you aim for the gate? Aim for the gate. Here. Okay, aim for the... You're missing the gate. Turn. Turn to the right. You're gonna hit the fence. Okay, now turn to the left a little bit. Come on, we can do it. Oh, no power steering. There you go, we made it. Woohoo! That was not scary at all, was it, girls?
It was a little bit scary.
Do you see her yet?
No. Wait, what's that?
What's that over there? Is that her? Her mommy stashed her here. So there she is. But that works out good, because then we can all go and see her. What, don't get too close?
Yeah.
Well, you...
I know how a grandpa get in.
Yeah.
I haven't been around a calf in a year.
You haven't been around a calf in a year?
I present to you Faith, number one calf.
What's her name?
Faith.
Faith? That's a good name. Hiding them. Well, one of the interesting things is when they're born, their hooves are really soft. But you can see that because they're so soft when she's born, that she gets up and walks around, and it automatically like starts tearing it off.
Is that supposed to happen?
Yeah. Yeah, that's supposed to happen.
Is it kind of like baby teeth?
Kind of like baby teeth, yeah.
Hey,
I think she likes you, Grace. She says, I like you. Oh, mom's far away. So because she's over here by herself, if her mom doesn't come and take care of her, we'll have to take her to her mom. And we probably won't do that unless she doesn't come get her by tonight. So we'll let her lay out here. She's nice and warm. You can feel how warm she is.
Yeah.
She's super warm.
So what's the calf's body temperature? And what's the calf's temperature supposed to be? Around
102? Yeah, 101, 102 degrees. Why is she so warm, do you think?
Well, she's out here in the sun.
Yeah? But we're out in the sun too, and I'm not really warm.
It's because she has all the fur that's keeping her warm, but also the sun's keeping her warm.
Yeah? And what about her color? Do you think that helps?
Yeah. Her color is black.
Right.
Black Angus. So.
Yeah, and the black fur soaks up all the sun because it's black, and it makes it warmer. So things that are black are warmer sometimes. Look, she's getting up for you. She wants to play? Faith. That. Yeah, they do that. Hi. Hi.
Oh, yucky. Ew. Poop. No, cool, Mom.
What's the matter, Lincoln? That's her umbilical cord. Look at that. She likes the tweels too. She says those are super cool. So one of the things that's funny with these little calves is they don't have very good eyesight. So when they see like something black and big, they might think it's their mom. Because that's what they see is, you know, their mom is like just a big black blob.
Where is my mom?
Yeah, she's looking for her
mom. She might try to suck.
Okay, let's jump in the gator. We're gonna leave her here. She can hang out. It's okay, we'll see her again.
After we find the mom, can we come back? Mom might follow us.
She might.
Because we have cake in here. Gracie, hide the cake.
I don't know if mom is much of a fan of cake.
Just in case, hide it. In that case, hide it now.
Don't run over her.
I won't run over her. All right, let's go find mom. What number are we keeping an eye out for?
130. That means like mostly the one of us are calves.
So like I said, sometimes moms, especially our very early moms, they forget that they have calves. You know, like
130 a new mom?
Well, no, but she's the first one of the season, so. There's not a bunch of calves running around out here to remind her that there's babies. So she goes and kind of forgets. But once her milk... Yeah, once her milk fills in, she'll remember she has a baby right away. So we're just going to drive around a little bit and see if we can find her, okay?
It's just 130,
wait,
right?
That's a number one calf.
That's yours.
I am the number one calf.
Oh, that might be, I think that's her right there. So see how that cow's walking?
Yeah.
It looks like she's on a mission, right?
Yeah.
So let's go and see if we can see if that looks like, I bet you that's her. Just the way that cow's walking over there, she just looks like she's got a purpose. Like she's got something to do, right? I think that's her. All right, we're gonna go ahead and just kind of move her towards her calf, okay? So we're gonna just kind of give her a little nudgy and say, hey, go get your baby. Say, don't forget to go get your baby today. We need that baby. And I think she knows where she's going because she's coming. But should we make sure?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll follow her for a little bit, yeah.
Oh.
So we want her to keep going towards her baby, but there's kind of a river in the way. She went the wrong way, man. Might have to go swimming. She's gonna get to her baby. It's just gonna take a little bit of work.
Don't lose faith yet.
Don't lose what'd you say? Don't lose faith. Don't lose faith. Well, mommy might have lost faith already. That's okay, we'll figure it out.
I meant like don't lose faith, I meant like don't give up, but then I was gonna say that, but I was like, oh no, the calf of their face, so I'm like, that would be a funny joke.
Yeah, it would be a funny joke. You're a good joke. Yeah, you're a good jokester. You're going the wrong way.
Wait,
I'm a cow at a ball.
All right, what do you think we should do?
I think we might have to bring the baby to her.
You want
to
bring the baby to her?
Yeah, but there's a little bit more time with the baby.
She sneezes.
You want to go for a ride? Think you could get her to sit in the back with you?
Then I want to ride in the back.
Yeah.
I want to be where the cow is.
The bad part is if we put her in the back, she'll try to stand up and walk out and jump out. Blink. Okay. You can sit down on that net wrap there. Okay. So I think Faith is going to have to sit on my lap and just look out the window. Okay, now, hey, put your head out the window. There you go. Okay. Okay. Now.
Now we got to go find Mama and bring.
Okay, this is harder than it looks. Okay. Is this fun or what?
With the riding with the baby calf, yes.
You guys get the butt in, though. I should have spun her around the other way.
Yeah.
You guys could have looked at her face, but she kind of likes looking out the window, I think. Hey, no, no, no. Settle down. Hey. Ah, dang it. Ah, settle down. You're okay.
I'll
You're okay.
Peeing.
What's she doing?
She's peeing.
She's peeing? That's nice. Okay.
He does
pee
for nice.
Oh, yeah, my leg's all wet. Ew, she peed on me.
I'm happy I'm by the window.
Now it smells like pee in here.
I'm happy I'm by the window.
Stinky.
I don't know. It's
horrible. Well, at least we know she had something to drink. Now, here's the funny part. We'll take her calf back to her. She won't say thank you. She won't appreciate it. She won't say, oh my gosh, you guys are so nice for bringing my calf to me.
I would say that if I was a cow.
I know, right? Their cows are kind of rude. Yeah, they don't say thank you. That was one of your Grandpa Gilbert's favorite things to say, is every time I would go out and cake the cows or I'd give the cows some food, he'd say,
thank you.
He'd say, the cows thank you. And I'd say, no, they don't. They never thank me. That was one of his favorite jokes.
Bambi.
The cows say thank you.
Bambi definitely says thank you.
1:30. Hey, Mama.
Kathy.
Look what I found.
The calf. She's following.
Following the wrong cow.
Oh, the mama's following.
There we go. Well, maybe.
Oh, she, yep.
There we go.
Hi, Dad. Come on. He doesn't want to. You don't want to come back in?
There they figured it out. She's with the right mom.
Thank goodness. My mama.
So there we go.
Okay.
All right, another day done on the ranch. Well, at least for us. We still have lots to do. Checking cows pretty much throughout the evening. I think we're gonna sneak into town and get the kids some ice cream at a cool little drive-through ice cream place that we know. And calving season has begun. It always starts out kind of slow. We'll do this. We'll probably have a calf tomorrow. That would be my guess. And then within a week or so, we're gonna really start to get going. And it's in that time frame that I want to bring you along for 24 hours of calving here on the ranch. We're going to do a 24-hour long live stream, and I'll announce it coming up, but we are going to basically just have a camera with me 24 hours throughout the entire day, following me around, doing whatever I'm doing, and bringing you right along with me. So that should be a lot of fun. Also, this weekend being Easter, just to let you know that we are not doing our live stream this weekend on Sunday night on the channel Beyond the Ranch. We're going to be taking that day off so that we can spend time with our families. But that's not going to screw up the 30 and 30. We're going to keep that rolling, 30 vlogs in 30 days. There's no stopping. That train is a-going, so nobody's getting in the way of that. So that's pretty much it for me. I'm going to hang things up. Thanks to the kids for coming out with me today and having a little bit of fun also. I know that we probably didn't really have to pick up that calf and take it to its mom, but with the kids with me, I really did want to show them, you know, what's involved and how important it is that we do take care of our animals. So once they start worrying about it, you know, you can't tell them, hey, it's not that big a deal. But it is something that they need to worry about as well. So it's very nice that they have that that same level. So there's a bunch of schmutz on my camera. Oh, it's all scratched up. That's nice to know. Well, another camera in the future. All right, guys, thanks, take it easy. Be sure to subscribe, follow along on Facebook and Instagram, and of course, head on over to the website, ourwyominglife.com. Thanks.